Hey guys, Kevin. Today we're going to talk about how to take the mainboard out of Epson ET-8550. And this video is shot in the lab, so there will be some background noises. And here's Abby.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'm going to be explaining and showing how to take out the mainboard to your ET-8550 printer. So we're going to go ahead and take out all the screws on this side of the printer, and then we'll work on moving this side panel off. So if you just push it backwards, you might have it get stuck on that back long piece. Now I popped it off. Once I got that piece off, I'm going to just work on taking off this back long panel. If you move it towards you at an angle, I found that best to get it off. Just point it downwards a little bit and move it towards you at an angle. Now we're on the other side, and there's a screw on the top in the back, a screw on the bottom in the back, and then open up the top of the scanner and open up the gray cover where the ink is. Open up the last blue tab to the ink, and you're going to need to use a different size screwdriver, but then take that screw out, and that should release everything to be able to take off this side cover. So again, just it took me a little bit to pull it off, but from where we just took that last screw out, if you pull that little notch where that screw goes out, it made it a little easier to pull it out and then push backwards. All right, so now we're looking at the other side of the printer again, where the main board is. Take out that cable, the white one with the gray and two whites, and then the two small FFC cables. So we're trying to release this front panel. I just used my finger just to see if it wiggles a little bit to see it's disconnected. Again, we're flipping the printer over to the other side now. And on this, you'll see this gray area. We take the screw out and we're on the top of the printer now, opening up that gray cover where the ink is. There's gonna be two screws up there. Taking those out, and we have the printer flipped over on its back now, so it's sitting upwards. And this is where we're trying to pry off a little bit of the pry these tabs on the bottom, and we're gonna lift off the front panel. All right, we have the front panel off, and the front panel comes off because we disconnected the two FFC cables and the white cable. And now we're just going in disconnecting everything else that goes to our main board. So look in the back, behind this little power area.
You have a question about these steps, or you cannot figure out which cable is for which, and we have a detailed documents that are going to help you. You can go to bchtechnology.com and search for ET8550, or I'll just put a link above this video. They'll have detailed instructions.
Once you have disconnected the back, we're going to disconnect the front of the main board. There is a little piece of tape here. You may or may not have to remove it to disconnect that wire. Just go back and check to make sure you have everything disconnected, all FFC cables and wires and everything. Then we need to remove the ground wires. There's one on the left side. And we also have another one that is on the right side as well. You'll see them. They're pretty easy to spot. Now we need to take this bottom screw out of the main board so we can release the main board. Be careful of this disc here. You don't want to scratch it. It is pretty flimsy, so it's easy to move back like that. Now flip the printer over on its side, and we're going to take the two screws out from the bottom that is holding the main board in place. And once you do that, you should be able to slide the main board out. And then you've taken your main board out of your ET8550 printer. Happy printing, everyone!